Hello and welcome back to yet another episode of the Fact Flashers Real Talk. Now, the Democrats in the United States of America have come into power. Joe Biden, who's said to be one of the most elderly presidents, has come into power in the United States of America, along with Kamala Harris, who's the first black woman, apart from being the Indo-American woman, to come into power as the vice president, which is a moment of pride for the entire India. Now, apart from that, the American election, a festival where the Indians were much more involved than they were involved in the Bihar elections itself, which tells us how important or how interested the Indians are into the American elections. But somewhere or the other, the question is that how important is it for the Indians? How is it going to affect the Indians if Democrats come into the power or if Republicans come into power? Donald Trump, as expected, is not happy with what has happened. And there are a lot of things that are going on in America as well. Now, this morning, I have been joined by senior advocate Kush Brahmbhatt. And over the next few minutes, we'll be talking to him on how Democrats coming into power in the United States of America is going to affect us as a country and affect us as Indians, because Indians have said to have a massive majority in America, in particular the Gujaratis as well. And what is it that they want? How is it going to affect them? How is it going to affect all of these students that study in the United States of America? Thank you so much, Kush, for being here with us.
Thanks, Krishna.
Like I said, the Democrats have come into the power.
Yes.
The most awaited moment. Indians were more focused on US elections than on Bihar elections.
Yeah.
And how do you think this is going to make a difference to India?
See, Krishna, this is always like, as said, that, you know, once people go through a certain process, a certain government completes its tenure, then they have their own experiences, right? So this is... As we see results, it is a very blatant response to Trump that he is not needed in America. What could be gazed out? But at a similar time, understand, there are always two types of party that has been playing role in American elections since long. One is Republican and second is Democratic. As the name suggests, Republican Party has been always more focused on, a free regime for business developments, than focused on, very much American-centric development, and so has been their policies. So when we talk about Democrats have also been a very good friend of India.
Right.
During the regime of Barack Obama, we have seen that they have, the current elected president, Joe Biden, by then, was then the vice president.
Right.
He told in 2006 when he was vice president and was working with Barack Obama in a perspective with Indian bilateral contracts and all. He told that there would be two superpowers that will be coming, and one will be USA and another will be India.
Right.
So he has been focused that India is going to be one of the biggest superpower, and it has been always like this. You know, when we talk about a US president talking about India, we Indians always feel a certain kind of joy that, you know, because we see them as a superpower.
Right.
At the same time, in addition to it, Kamala Harris is again someone from Indian background, has become a vice president. Brightly looking forward to it, we can see that Joe Biden has nearby age, which will allow him for one term to be a president.
Right.
Then another option will be Kamala Harris as a president for United States. So there are a lot of bright perspectives. And when we see Biden regime as vice president of United States of America, at that particular moment, we could briefly say that there were many things wherein he was interested at that particular time to work with India on certain perspectives.
Right.
They were ready for defense mechanism contracts and all kind of knowledge sharing on basis of both and mutual development for India also. So, and looking forward to current India's foreign policy, we could also again that we are a country that has been very politely working with each and every neighborhood states in their development also, because we believe that, you know, everybody, entire world is our family. So when such philosophy has been emphasized, I feel that there are very bright, there is a very bright future for both the great countries that hold a very big relevance to their, you know, old and very periodical and very, you know, there are many learnings that both the countries have had in their past election experiences. So definitely Biden and Harris are going to be one of the biggest assets for India when again Mr. Narendra Modi will be visiting US states basically. So this is going to be great, what right. I could feel at this moment. But I won't say that Trump was not good. Understand, being a Republican candidate, he has always supported his the ideology of the party. And but yeah, there are always some, you know, bad things that come up again and again. So this is what democracy is all about.
Question, very simple words. Biden coming into power, Kamala Harris, or the Democrats coming into power.
Yeah.
How is it going to affect people like you and me?
See, understand, there is a very simple thing. Whenever we talk about a small, what you can say, a small market adoption, there are a lot of things that US learns from India and India learns from US.
Absolutely.
Right? There are a lot of bilateral agreements. There are a lot of things that go behind when a prime minister of India goes to America. The president comes out, receives him. Understand, this is the feeling where every Indian feels that, you know, after a certain point of time, we have got a focused leadership and a vision named Narendra Modi. And the way he has been dealing with America, when we talk about Trump thought of, carrying out a dialogue with Pakistan in regard to Kashmir.
Mm.
The answer itself that, they could talk with Kashmir because we are clear with what we want to do
right.
with Pakistan in respect to that. So this type of thing, and at the same point of time, when we go back to Barack Obama, where Biden was then the vice president, at that point of time, he was very careful about the things that he is going to touch in India. Because they were very sure that there are certain areas like wherein India will be welcoming them, and there will be certain perspectives wherein India wouldn't be negotiating with America on any basis. So, and now, definitely, understand, like both, like you and me, what will we be gaining?
Mm-hmm.
The major perspective is that we will be seeing two strengthening nations coming together, fighting against terrorism, and lot of other perspectives that were till now been deliberately, you know, not been taken into focus. But India is going to be a next superpower that will be dealing, and US will be supporting it.
Right.
In terms of terrorism, what I am very sure of.
Now, Gush, another important discussion that has begun is that Donald Trump and Narendra Modi shared a very, very, very strong bonding. And this is something that they have been very vocal about.
Vocal about, yeah.
So something or the other, do you think, is it going to affect the relationship that PM Narendra Modi is going to have with Joe Biden? Or is it somewhere or the other? Because, you know, they have been very vocal about how good friends they are.
See, understand, when we see Narendra Modi's friendship terms with any of the, presidents or prime ministers of different countries and states, it has been very different opinion about Narendra Modi, that he keeps, as a prime minister, he talks in a different manner, and as a person, he talks in a different manner. We could see when he hosted Trump, when he hosted Xi Jinping, he brought them here, he spectacularly made them see that what is the land where he belongs to,
right?
What is the craze of people for him,
right?
When we talk about Biden, definitely Narendra Modi once said that I do not take people's perspective when I meet any person, because it is based upon the experiences that they had. So it is not certain that I will also have the same experiences. And this is the same case that happened with Trump. When he met Trump first, there were a lot of news channels and a lot of people, a lot of diplomats were saying that this might not go well, because the way Trump used to take decisions was very different than other US presidents that we have witnessed. But it came out differently. Then you see US defending India in each and every sector. Then you see you know, Narendra Modi welcoming Trump here, and then you know, when Modi was there at Times Square, we witnessed one of the biggest gatherings, and at that point of time, when we see the dialogues that happened, this is very clear that Narendra Modi's friend Trump will be always a good friend, but Biden is also going to be a very good friend of Narendra Modi, because he is a person who takes the talk on the walk. So let's see that how Mr. Modi gets this entire scenario in his benefit. But it is going to help India again, because there are a lot of international affairs that, you know, that might not concern us as an individual, that but that might concern the entire India security and a lot of different issues.
Right. Now, one last question.
Yeah.
That somewhere or the other, there were two similarities that were seen in India when the elections were fought, and now in America when they're being fought. In India, when we, somewhere or the other, the BJP, the ruling party, wants to bring in NRC, NCA, all of these affairs. And on the other hand, Biden or their party, Democratic in particular, want to do something of the similar sort with, they want to work for Americans rather than working for the rest of the people there. So somewhere or the other, do you think that this might either clash or either they might come together with this?
See, understand, when we talk about India and NRC, that is a different thing.
Mm.
We are very focused about that, you know, nobody should be discriminated on basis of religion.
Right.
Right. But see, understand, Krishna, when we talk about NRC, CAA in India, it's a most required, you know, law that is going to be implemented, and that is being implemented, rather. Why? The only question that I want to ask is, doesn't Indian citizenship seen as a very common feature? Everybody celebrates when they get green card of America, but nobody has, I have seen, celebrated being, you know, taking India as a, Indian as a citizenship. So I feel that this is a perspective that what, you know, approaches me to support CANRC, because my citizenship is equivalent to any other nation's citizenship, right? So being an Indian, I'm also proud. And the entire, see, understand, this is going to be most interpreted thing that has been going around, that people are very focused about religion specific, right? When we talk about America, it is very simple. They have said that any person coming into boundary of America without a citizenship goes through a certain process. They have given them relief also, right? Relief as in what? So they could stay for 2 years, they could get more amended 2 years of leave for America if they want to stay, and they need to go through a certain process to get their citizenship. So this is what India wants.
Right.
If you want to come to our country, then you need to go through a certain process, and that is the least a country could ask for. Then why there should be such a hullah that is going on?
Right.
Right. And specifically, see, understand, currently when Democrats are going to be one of the ruling parties in America, this is a very specific thing that Democrats have been always open, you know, while accepting these things. Even when we talk about Barack Obama's social security amendments that he came with, it was usually appreciated by every black and every white of America. But then Trump completely barred it.
Right.
Right. So there are a lot of perspectives that Biden has to work for. If he wants to reinstate the faith of Americans in Democrats, then this is going to be a very hard and very hard-working tenure for Biden and Harris as well.
Right. Thank you so much, Kush, for being here with us.
Great,
it's
great,
always
yeah.
great to discuss things with you.
Thank you.
So this was Senior Advocate Kush Brahmbhatt with me. And like all of us know, that Joe Biden and Kamala Harrison have made it to power in the superpower of the world, the United States of America. Now, what we have to see is that the relations of India and America will get stronger, and they should get stronger with time, and we're sure about it. Now, with this and a lot more that you need to know, make sure that you stay with us always. Thank you. Thank you.